Hey guys, what's up? This is Samir Bakriwal here and I'm pretty excited. Oh wait, this is my first YouTube channel. Okay, so I can tell you about myself a little bit. I'm a small boy, not that small, 15 years old boy. And I'm a YouTube addict and a technological guy. So I combined those both. And I came up with an idea to start my own YouTube channel. So there you go, my friends. This is my first YouTube video and I hope you guys like it. So let's get started.
You can do this.
So along with the iPhone 6s and 6s Plus, Apple released their iDock for the iPhones that are sporting the lightning cable, and it's pretty awesome. I wanted to take my hands on that dock, but it's not released in India yet. And it's in the Android market for past long time. And me being an Android user, I wanted to buy such a thing. And me being a student, I couldn't buy that thing. Makes sense. So I thought I should make that thing myself. And look where we are. That's right. This is my own handmade dock for my Android phone. Let's have a closer look. Okay, so as I told you, I'm a YouTube addict. When I decided I should make my own charging dock, I searched YouTube for many ideas and I got some pretty good videos. But the only problem I had is the materials they used. They used wood and axe and many sizes of drills, which I'm pretty sure most of you cannot use. So I took the idea and I made it with my own materials. And today I'm going to tell you how to make it. I hope you can make it at home with ease. Looking at this thing from the start, the only thing that comes to my mind that it is a beast. Well, when I was designing how to make this dock, I kept in mind that it should look pretty rough, but at the same time should have a really simple form factor. Keeping that in mind, I cut out the layout for this dock pretty uneven, and which gave the sides of this dock a really good texture, nice grooves and good feel in the hand. Another thing I want to highlight about the sides of this dock is the shine that is created. Well, this is mostly due to the mixture of paint I use, about which I'm going to tell you about a bit later. Coming to the top of this dock, well, this is where things start get more interesting. If you can see, the sides of the top have been given an extra layer of height, which gives it a more bolder look. The center have been given a leathery texture, which is accompanied by stitches, well, fake stitches, and my logo, which I am still working on. This gives it a really good feeling from whichever angle you see. Now coming to the main part of the dock, this is where the phone fits. This is the charging port, and this is the speaker outlet, which is connected to the main area from where the sound comes out from. As this phone is made according to my Xiaomi Mi 4, I use the measurements according to my phone. As you can see, the charging port and the speaker outlet. So this is how the phone fits on the dock, and let's see how this dock works. Okay, so as you can see, I have connected my dock to the power plug point, and now I'll show you how easy it is to connect your smartphone to your dock. There you go, it is as simple as that. So now I'll tell you certain tips on how to make a dock like this at your home without any need of any hardware. So let's get going. The key to make a really good dock like this is to have really precise cutouts and really good measurements. In my case, I used measurement of 12 by 8 centimeters. Of course, this was suiting the size of the phone of mine, and I really needed something bulky to make it feel better. And for the center where the phone goes in, as you can see here, I took the measurement 1 by 7, because that's the measurement of the bottom of my phone. So keeping that in mind, I design all the rest pieces, which I've divided into 5 layers to make it easier for you to understand. The topmost layer is this layer, which gives the dock a bit of height, but I kept it till 3 layers because I wanted to keep the notifications shade of my phone, as you can see here. And then I used this layer, which from where the power plug charge enters, as you can see. And this is for the speaker grill. The next point I want to highlight is that I have just cut out one layer just to give you an idea. In real life, you have to make at least 3 of these layers just to give it a height, and most of the height is dependent upon the length of your wire you're taking. In my case, it was not pretty long, so it just took me this much to make it. So 3 of these setup, 3 of these just to give it some height, and it's completely dependent upon your phone. Then comes this layer, which as you can see gives the speaker some place. If kept below this layer, this layer just adds to the altitude and also accompanies this part, the charging cable. So if you take 6 of these, it will give the altitude for your speaker. Again, I want to tell you, if your phone doesn't have a speaker at the bottom, you don't need to worry about it. You can just make it as simple, and you just need to cut out this part. So continuing, this part will come below this part, as this will accompany the wire. Again, the cutout for this part will be depending on the size and the breadth of your wire. So keeping that in mind, I made this cutout, and everything is matching. So if I keep this above this, then this, and at the bottom this. This is how the layout might work. Putting these through. Therefore, the number of layers you use depends upon the height of this part. And at the end, you use this part, that's the base, which will fold the wire and give everything a base. So there you go, this is the idea for the dock. Okay, so now as you have got the idea on how to make the dock, it's time for some useful tips. Tip number one. Use a good kind of charger, preferably the one that comes with the phone would do the job. Because as I told you earlier, the cable of the charger you're using has to take a bend like this, and if the charger is not good enough, it will break here and it will affect the charging speed. So if it's a good charger, the charging will not be affected, and that would be good for your dock. And if possible, use a power charger, because that will be much more effective. Tip number two. When you're cutting out the cutout for the plug, remember that it should be of exact measurement for the plug, so that you have to force the plug a little bit inside the hole, what will that do? That connecting all the layers together, it will make a strong bond which will prevent the layers from moving here and there, which itself will be very strong without any need of adhesive. So guys, as I promised, I'll tell you how I achieved the shine on the sides of this dock is because of the mixture that I created between the paint and the Fevicol, which not only gives the amazing shine on the sides of this dock but also keeps it intact and gives it a very good texture at the same time. Okay, so guys, my last tip is that if there's a place where you charge your phone more frequently, place where you study or work, place near your desktop, then I recommend you to stick your dock in the nearby place using a double-sided tape. That will make it more efficient and help you enjoy it more and more. The last thing I wanted to tell you is, no matter whatever I tell you, the design is completely at your preference, and make whatever you want to make, and don't forget, be creative. Okay, so to wrap things up, I'm pretty excited because this is the end of the video, and as I told you earlier, this is my first video, so I don't know much of what to do, but if you like this video, I hope you have. So please hit the like button at the bottom of this screen, and also don't forget to subscribe because some help would always be appreciated. Ooh, I almost forgot. If you have any questions, you can ask me right down there in the comment section below.
Hmm.